So there's certain things in this game that you could look at. Obviously, the Yankees played a sloppy game. They didn't get much going offensively. But down 4-2 in the seventh inning, first two runners get on. First and second, Kyle Higashioka is at the plate. So we start at that point. They're down by two. Now, in analytics, you don't like to give away outs with the bunt. You've always said thank you if you're a pitcher. Do you think about Higashioka bunting there?
Well, I think it's a legitimate debate to have. You're right, Michael. 4-2. You got the bottom of the order coming up. Higashioka's obviously down towards the bottom of the order. Not really an established major league hitter, so it's a very debatable point. On the flip side, though, on the mound, the pitcher was trying to implode. You could see he was losing the strike zone a little bit. He fell behind Kyle in that situation. I think, you know, besides the bunt, him swinging at a ball on 3-1 was probably something that, you know, and Paul said it, maybe take a strike there at that point in the game, kind of let him off the hook.
Now, because of the player that you are, you know, as you said during the broadcast, you're the backup to the backup. If Gary Sanchez is here, you're not. Do you make yourself take that pitch, or do you say, hey, 3-1 pitch is the one I could drive, and maybe I put the team in the lead?
Yeah, but you got to look at who you are. And again, this is me talking up in the booth and not being down on the field. He was committed. He got beat on a pitch inside, but I think you have to realize what is happening. You've got a pitcher out there that is on a roll, but he's really, really struggling. If you take a pitch, he still has to throw another strike. And if you get bases loaded, you might be in the bullpen at that point. So in my mind, it wasn't Terrell. His double play ball, it was that at bat right there where he popped up.
And the thing you could criticize or second guess, which is easy right now, mm-hmm. he doesn't move the runners along and the ground ball turns into a double play. Maybe it turns into a run and makes it 4-3, and it's a completely different story. In one story, it's kind of strange. Tanaka was cruising, then all of a sudden, I'm not going to say he lost it because there were two infield hits, but then he started to get hit a little bit harder.
Well, he did, you know, and he ended up giving up four of his hits were on the infield variety, and they bunched the infield hit, so that kind of put him in the jam. And obviously, when you're up 2-0, Tanaka was cruising. You think you're in pretty good shape. He's going to hold it right there, but it fell apart on him. It was a little bit of a Murphy's Law inning for Tanaka there. I thought he pitched pretty well. You know, he deserved a better fate in my mind. But after he gave up the lead 3-2, right then I'm thinking maybe the change should have been made there. Turned out it didn't really matter. The Yankees couldn't get anything going offensively.
And finally, we talked about this toward the end of the game. They've won 8 of 9, and it's hard to argue when a team has won 8 of 9, but Paul, this team has put itself in a situation because of getting swept 4 games by Boston that they have to win all these games, and it's hard to lose a game to the White Sox.
Well, again, I mean, you look at the long picture. The big picture is they put themselves in a position where they should be in first place. They're 30-some games over 500. They're playing against a team who is having a historic season. So you don't look at every game as, you know, are we in it? Are we out of it? You have to close the book on this. You can't get them back, but you do have to realize that you've got, you got 5 more games, 6 more games on this homestand, and you do have a big West Coast trip coming up. You've got to make some ground up here because you can't expect to go out and have great things happen on the West Coast.